Hello, good morning and welcome to Walking in His Presence. I'm Pastor Dave Lasek, pastor of In His Presence Church right here in the South Hills area. And it is our pleasure to come to you via BPTV on a weekly basis and just share what God puts on our heart for you. We come each week with a little tidbit that hopefully will help you in your walk with the Lord. Hopefully will enable us all to grow in the love and the admonition of God. And so we come each week and just take a piece or a portion of scripture or a topic that we're speaking into, that I'm speaking into. And we've been going over, like say we, for all of you who regularly join us. And if this is the first time, well, welcome. And just make note of the date and the time and the station that you found us on, and tune back in again. Or if you're watching via YouTube, we welcome you from anywhere around the world, and we're excited that you're with us. Each week we come and we talk about a specific aspect of our walk with the Lord and how we can come to a better understanding of that and hopefully enhance our time with God. Since the beginning of the year, we've been tracking with a scripture out of the book of the prophet Jeremiah. In Jeremiah chapter 29, the prophet speaks a profound word, and we've been using that as our basis for this whole first part of the year. Here we are beginning our the sixth month, and we have just taken this scripture and used it to run with in various forms and fashions over these past shows. The scripture is in Jeremiah 29, and in verse 11, the prophet says something that is absolutely profound. And as you sit back to think about that, you begin to, I don't know if you're like me, I begin to question, well, how? Why? When does that happen? How does God make this work for me? The scripture says this. It says, I know the plans and the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope. And when you call upon me, it says in verse 12, and go and pray to me, I will listen to you, and you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all of your heart. And then he says something unique. He says something in verse 14. It says, I will be found by you, says the Lord, and I will bring you back from your captivity and gather you from all the nations and places where I have driven you and bring you to a place that I have caused you to be. The Lord is telling us right there that we need to search him out. There's a scripture that we've covered here in Proverbs. It says, the glory of God to conceal a matter. It's the glory of kings to search it out. And so God speaks to us. He says, I have plans for you. But it requires us to press into him and say, okay, Lord, what are your plans for me? Because you know that if it's God's plans for you, they're the best. They're the best. They're going to be better than anything we could come up with, better than anything any other man can come up with. It's going to be the best of the best for you. And so when God says, I know the plans that I have for you, that excites me. That excites me. And it excited me so much. I began this year with this scripture, and it's just been a powerful time of searching and saying, you know, just interrogatory questions. How? When? Where? Why would you have plans for me? What are your plans? We took a look at ways in which God conveys those plans. And over the past so many shows, we've been looking at the ways that God speaks. He speaks through his word. He says, I exalt my word in Psalm 138. Verse 2, he says, I exalt my word even above my name. Now that's a huge, that's a wow statement. That says God really elevates the Bible, the word of God. It, to him, that is such an important gift to us and to us who know the Word or are studying or seeking or reading the Word on a regular basis, we begin to find out what a precious gift God has given us in His Word. So many times I can tell you just from Bible reading, just from reading what seemingly would be unconnected with what's going on in my life, all of a sudden, like large skyscrapers coming out of the ground, the words that I needed to hear, the words that I needed to make a decision, the words that I needed for comfort, for direction, just leap off the page to me. That's the Holy Spirit showing us here. God knows where you're at. He knows what you need, and He is intimately involved in your life. That's exciting, folks. The God of all the universe is intimately and passionately and intentionally involved in your life. You matter to Him. And I just, there's so much going on where there's actually a segmentation of our society through all these different types of this color and that color, and this life matters and that life matters. Well, God is all-encompassing. All lives matter. From the first cell of life, God says, life is good. I have given life, and it matters to me. And that's why we can't stand in favor of abortion, because God brings life. And from the very first second, the very first moment of existence, God is intimately involved and has called that life forth. No one can give life but God. And so we have to cherish life so dearly and protect it and enhance our life through our relationship with Him. And we build that relationship by hearing Him speak to us. And we've been discussing how God speaks. And of course, number one, as I said, through His Word. He speaks through others, where somebody will come up and they'll say something, and then all of a sudden, just as the words leaped off the page, the words coming out of somebody's mouth, even though what their statement is may be totally unrelated to what you've been pressing and asking God for, all of a sudden, bam, you know that God used them to convey His message to you. And that's the work of the Holy Spirit, is He gives us ears to hear and eyes to see. I can't tell you the number of different ways that God has communicated His love, His concern, His direction, and His compassion toward me. I mean, just having coffee with a friend, and all of a sudden a statement will be made, and that statement, even though it was in the context of a different subject, that statement draws me to understand in a totally different situation going on that God is intimately involved in on my behalf. So we take a look at the Word. We take a look at others. We can take a look at providential circumstance, it's called in some places. Providential or divine appointments. Have you ever bumped into somebody or met somebody, and then all of a sudden the things that you needed in your life was something that this person was all about? You didn't know them. You may have met them at a grocery store. You may have met them at the gas station or the filling pump. And all of a sudden, by a unique connection, you find that peace that you need. Well, that's not by happenstance. That's not a coincidence. That's what the world would call it. But I believe that God orchestrates and ordains our steps. That's what the Word of God tells us. That's what it says, Thy Word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. This Word, this Word of God is so important to us. It directs that statement, thy word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. We've mentioned that here. Well, that means that he's involved in the direction of our steps, and not just our immediate steps, but our journey. He's involved in our steps and our journey. Thy word, the word of God, will direct our steps and decisions for today, the near and the close and the upfront, problems and situations and decisions to be made. The word of God has direction for that. But it also gives us through those steps, it gives us directional insight. It gives us directional fortitude and foresight for what may or may not be happening. And so God's word is a lamp to my feet, and it's a light to my path. A light shines out. When I think of that word, I think about like a lighthouse. How, you know, a man walks from his house to his garage, and he may need a flashlight. He may need a lantern. He may need some kind of a light with him to watch his steps. But the lamp house is the light that shines forward, shines and illuminates a region or illuminates a path. That's the word of God to me. It's the lamp for my feet, but it's the light that shines ahead and dispels darkness. Darkness can never overcome light. And when God's word sheds light on something, darkness must be expelled. And I'm so excited about the word of God. I just, the psalmist David says, I love your word. I love your word, God. He says, I long to meditate on it day and night. In fact, let me turn to that because I feel like God wants us to read this one other time here. The longest psalm in the Bible is Psalm 119. And I believe I may have read this at one time or another, but it never hurts to hear it again. In that psalm, the psalmist says and speaks to the impact of the Word of God. It says in verse 9 of Psalm 119, how can a young man cleanse his way? By taking heed according to your word. How can a man keep his way pure? Some verses say, by heeding to the word of God. With my whole heart I've sought you. Oh, let me not wander from your commandments. Your word I have hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. Blessed are you, O Lord. Teach me your statutes. With my lips I've declared all the judgments of your mouth. I have rejoiced in the way of your testimonies as much as in all riches. I will meditate on your precepts and contemplate your ways. I will delight myself in your statutes. I will not forget your word. That is a powerful section of Scripture. It tells us very clearly that if we've made mistakes, if we've gotten off of God's path for us, if we've gone down a road that has not led to good things, God's word has, first of all, compassion, second of all, forgiveness, and third of all, direction for us to get back on the correct path. I don't know who I'm talking to today, but I'm talking to somebody who's been challenged. They have been challenged, and they have perhaps maybe even made some wrong decisions, a couple wrong decisions, or gone a wrong direction in your life. All is not lost. God is here to say his word from wherever you are can direct you back. And there's a section of Scripture, without me turning to it right now, it says, where can I hide from you? If I go into the depths of the earth, you're there. If I go to the highest heaven, you're there. God is everywhere. And he desires for us to hear his direction, to hear the good things and the plans that he has for us. And as we press in and we begin to seek God on a regular basis, we begin to find those directions. We begin to hear His voice more clearly. And there's a scripture that says, how can I improve my direction, my relationship with you? And they say that things come through reason of use. Did you ever notice in just about any and every facet of life that you can try something for the first time and you might be able to get by? You try it the second time, you get a little bit better. By the 10th or 15th time, you've got it down. But the more you do that particular act or that particular thing, the more you use it, the more comfortable you become. And so through reason of use, we contemplate and apprehend the Word of God, the direction of God, through that consistent time with Him. If you're not spending time with God, excuse me, on a regular basis, I would encourage you to start in a very unique way. Today is actually the first of the month. As we're recording this and I'm sitting in the studio of BPTV, today is actually the 1st of June. I would encourage you, as soon as you find this online or as soon as you see this, consider what day of the month it is that you see it. On that day, turn to that number of the book of Proverbs. There's 31 days in a month, there's 31 Proverbs. Let's say you come across this show on the 8th of the month or the 7th of the month. Turn to Proverbs 7 and read Proverbs 7 for that day. The next day, open up to Proverbs 8 and go through those Proverbs one by one every day of the month. The day, the number of the proverb that matches the day of the month is an excellent beginning Bible study for you. It's how I began. I began to read those, and I began to see that God desires us to have wisdom. See, we can gain knowledge through study and through experience, but we can't gain, but wisdom only comes from God. Let's put it that way. Wisdom comes from God. And there was a statement, I just made this to a friend of mine the other day. I was saying, you know, there's a statement, I used to have it written out on almost like a name tag sticker thing. And I pasted it when I was growing up to my bedroom cupboard door. And this is what it said. It said, experience teaches thoroughly. You learn things through experience, both good and bad. And hopefully if your experience is bad, you learn what not to do. Hopefully if your experience is good, you learn how to do that again or how to even improve upon that. So experience does teach thoroughly. However, it devours men's ears. When it's at all possible, get wisdom. God says, I give wisdom freely to all men. That's what the scriptures say. I give wisdom freely to all men who ask of it. And so think about this. Let's take a step back here. We can do it ourselves and learn from our mistakes, or we can ask God and trust that He's going to direct our path into the ways of righteousness and success. I don't know about you, but after hammering your head against the wall for a few times, let me tell you, wisdom sounds a whole lot better. And the interesting thing is God's way, He directs our path in His righteousness. He gives us wisdom, and wisdom only comes from God. So therefore, we can supersede even our chronological age. If we teach our children to ask God for wisdom at a very young age, that wisdom will guide them and direct them. That wisdom will show them paths of righteousness and illuminate paths of unrighteousness to avoid. God has been so faithful to me, my wife, and our kids in that we have constantly told them, get wisdom, get wisdom. If you're not sure, wisdom asks for advice. Experience says, hey, I'll try this. And there's nothing wrong with trying it. Okay, don't get me wrong. But if I had the opportunity, especially in the greater a decision, the greater a direction, the greater importance a direction is, my first choice is always to find someone who has gone before me and ask for wisdom. What did you learn by this? How did that work for you? Okay, Dr. Phil's famous for his line, well, how's that working for you? Okay. In other words, you chose the way of experience. Tell me how that is. Okay. So God is saying, my ways are not your ways. And I feel I need to read that for someone right now. God makes clearly clear to us that he has a way in a matter and that he desires for us to seek him first, to seek the ways that he has for us. Let's see where we're at here. Not that one. I had Isaiah 43 in my mind here. Isaiah 43 says, don't remember the former things or consider the things of old. I'm going to do a new thing. Now it's going to spring forth. Will you not know it? I'll even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. You know, folks, the fact of the matter is that when God begins to move, we need to be ready. We need to realize that it can be in the supernatural, just like God had me turn to that verse there. It can be in things totally unexpected. God desires us as we stay in unison, in tight relationship with him. He begins to show us that those things that we may consider impossible are not impossible with him. God wants to move mountains for you. He wants you to realize his love for you through his exercise of that love by leveling mountains and raising up valleys. And so we it says, when you pass through the waters, I'll be with you. When you and through the rivers, they'll not overflow you. I'm reading in Isaiah 43 here. It says, and when you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. How more clear than that can God say, I am with you? But we have to come to the understanding that his ways are not our ways. His thoughts are not our thoughts. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so are his thoughts above our thoughts and his ways above our ways. As we allow God to direct our steps, as we come to him and say, Father, show us that direction you have for us. Lord, I have this challenge, this situation before me. What would you have for me in this situation? And listen with open ears to what God has for us. We begin to see the power and the majesty of God exercised on our behalf. Well, that's about all the time we have today. Hope you had a great Memorial Day weekend and enjoyed time with your family, honoring those who have paid the ultimate price for our freedom to be able to have shows and be able to openly teach the Bible, which in some countries it's not possible whatsoever. But hopefully you had a great Memorial Day weekend. And that's all the time that we have for today. Take note again of the time and the station that you found this, and tune in again next week as we find different things in the Word of God to help us in walking in his presence. I'm Pastor Dave Lasek, pastor of In His Presence Church. We meet every week at 10 a.m., and we'd love to have you. God bless you. Have a great day.